around you guys. It's just time to talk about preparing for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ again. He's about to come. The angels are about to appear in the sky with our Lord Jesus Christ. And the Christians are about to be translated. Those that rested first will be, those that rested in Christ will be translated first, and they'll go and meet up with him in the sky. Then the Christians, the ones that are living, will be translated, and they'll go and meet with him in the sky. And then he will go with him, with them, leading the way to heaven, so they can go and partake of the marriage supper that has been prepared for the children of God. Everything has been prepared, everything is ready. The saints in heaven are ready. The host of heaven is ready. Everything is ready. Our Lord Jesus Christ is ready to come and meet with us, to come and take us so that we can go and be partakers of the marriage supper. But the question is, are we ready? We Christians on earth, we are not ready. We Christians on earth, we've got a lot to do before we can talk about going to join our Lord Jesus Christ in the sky, so we can go with him and be partakers of the marriage supper. We have a lot to do. We have a lot to run away from. We have a lot to change. I got this message from the Lord last week, and I just wanted to talk about it because I could not keep it to myself. Why? Because so many people are busy here on earth, building mansions, making mansions, creating mansions, doing everything they can to have mansions, to live in mansions. Some of them live in big houses. Some of them live in one-bedroom flats, one-bedroom, two-bedroom house, three-bedroom house, four bedrooms, five bedrooms, no matter the number of bedrooms, even if it is one bedroom. This is your life here on earth. But the word says, when you die, be careful that you might live in a mansion here on earth. You might live in a two-bedroom house here on earth, but when you die, do you know where you're going? Do you know where you're going to end up? Many of us are going to end up in a space that is so tiny. Yet on earth they were living in a mansion. They had loads of space. They had a bedroom to their own, to themselves. But where they are going, when they are in hell, they are going to have a very small space. And many people do not know that. That the space that they are going to live in hell is so limited, because it's just going to be a pit. Say a pit that is one bedroom, big enough to be one bedroom. You might find 10 people in that room, or 20 people in that room, that room in hell. It's not just a small room, it's not just a small space, it's in hell as well, where they'll be burning. Some of them will be tied down. Their feet will be chained down. Their hands will be chained down. They can't even move. All they can do is stand sideways. They can't move even 5 meters from where they are. They can't go nowhere. They are just limited on that same space, on that same spot. But on earth, they were living in a mansion. On earth, they were living in a 10-bedroom house. But now they are limited. They've got no space. Maybe they just have one square meter. That is the space that has been allotted to them in hell. Why? Because of what they did on earth. Why? Because they did not prepare for where they were going after the life on earth. Why? Because they did not give them their lives to the Lord. Why? Because maybe they give their life to the Lord, but they did not walk after what the word of the Lord says they should do. They did not keep in their hearts what the word of the Lord says they should keep. The word says in Deuteronomy 6:36 that we should keep the word of the Lord in our hearts. But when we fail to keep the word of the Lord in our hearts, and we keep anything else that is not of the word of the Lord in our hearts, we end up in hell, where we have such a tiny limited space. Yet on earth we had mansions. Yet on earth we had 2-bedroom houses, 2-bedroom flats. But in hell we have a limited space, a very small space. Why? Because of what we did here on earth. Why? Because we failed to walk according to the commandments, the judgments, and the statutes of the Lord. We failed to do what the word of the Lord says we should do. The word of the Lord says we should keep the word of the Lord in our hearts and nothing else. The word of the Lord says we should run away from the works of the flesh. The moment we follow after the works of the flesh, even if we are born again Christians, even if we are tongue speaking, even if we serve in the house of the Lord, even if we've got titles in the house of the Lord, the moment we walk after the works of the flesh, we have gone astray. Even if it is in the house of the Lord, we have gone astray. Therefore, we end up in hell. It doesn't matter the title we have in the house of the Lord. It doesn't matter how long we've been serving in the house of the Lord. It doesn't matter
How many of us did it in the third world? As long as it is not right before the Lord, we end up in hell. Therefore, we've got to repent now and change now and make amendments now. Look at our ways. Look at what we're doing. Is it right before the Lord? If it is not right before the Lord, then we've got to repent and change and go back to the Lord so that on the last day, we'll be able to be partakers of the marriage supper. On the last day, we'll be able to go with him and live in the mansions that he prepared for us in heaven. Will not go to hell where there is limited space, where the space is so small that you can't even move, you can't even do nothing. You are just limited. Your feet are tied down, your hands are tied down, chained down, not even tied, but chained down. You can't move. You can't move 1 meter away from where you are. You can't move 2 meters away from where you are. You are just there forever. It's not good. We've got to run away from it. Why people end up in hell is because of the works of the flesh. We've got to run away from the works of the flesh because the works of the flesh profited us nothing. The works of the flesh leads us to hell. Whenever we follow the works of the flesh, we are following a road that leads to hell. We have got to run away from the road that leads to hell and look for the road that takes us to heaven. So today I'm talking about the works of the flesh. The works of the flesh that we have got to run away from so that we can go with our Lord Jesus Christ when he comes, so we can go with him and be partakers of the marriage supper. So that if we die before he comes, we'll be able to go and be in heaven. But the moment we follow the works of the flesh, we cannot go to heaven. Rita, we cannot go and live in those mansions. The mansions we built, we contributed towards when we were serving the house of God. And we contributed towards our mansions, and our mansions were built. But now, because of the works of the flesh, we cannot go and even see them. We cannot go and live in them. We now end up in hell. Why? Because of the works of the flesh. Rita, the Bible tells us about the works of the flesh, and today I'm talking about the works of the flesh, the works of the flesh that we have to run away from. Because they are not good. They are not of God, they are of the devil. So this is why the Bible tells us about the works of the flesh, so that we know about them and then we run away from them. In any way we've been practicing them, we've got to repent and go back to the Lord and ask him to forgive us. The Bible says in Galatians 5:19-21, now the works of the flesh are evident, which are adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contentions, jealousies, outbursts of wrath, selfish ambitions, dissensions, heresies, envy, murders, drunkenness, revels, and the like, of which I tell you beforehand, just as I also told you in time past, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. So whenever we practice the works of the flesh, as listed in Galatians 5:19-21, whenever we practice them, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. We cannot enter the kingdom of God. Rita, there is no space for us in heaven. There is no place for us in heaven. Why? Because of the works of the flesh. Maybe when you first gave your life to Jesus, maybe you were doing the right things. You were not following the works of the flesh. You were doing the proper things before the Lord. You were keeping the word. You were doing everything that is right. And the mansion was built for you in heaven. You contributed. It was built in heaven and everything was done. Everything was right. But now you have gone astray. Now you follow the works of the flesh. You know what? That mansion will be destroyed. That mansion will not be able to even to see it. That mansion will not be able to even to enter it. Why? Because of the works of the flesh. For example, if you were not drinking alcohol before, now, and then you were going to church and your mansion was built in heaven, everything was done, everything was ready, waiting for you, and then you started drinking alcohol, suddenly. Therefore, that mansion will be cracked, will be destroyed, will be out of bounds. You can no longer go there. You can no longer go and live in it. You can no longer go and see it. You can no longer go to heaven and live in that mansion, even though it had been built for you. Because when it was built for you, you were doing the right things. But now then you've gone astray. You have changed. Maybe that time you were not jealous, but suddenly you started becoming jealous. Because things like that, most of the things of the works of the flesh, they have got spirits behind them. So maybe when you gave your life to Christ, when you started, you were doing very well, you were doing right, the spirit was not in you. Then suddenly the spirit of jealousy came on you, and now you are jealousy. Up to a point that you have got to go to hell. You can't go to heaven. But the mansion had been built for you already. But because you have changed, because that spirit of jealousy is now in you, because you allowed it, you entertained it, and you kept it in you, it's now in you. That mansion will not be able to see it. That mansion will not be able to go and live in it. You end up in hell, where there is a limited space for you, where the space is so small, you can't even move. Most of the people, their hands will be chained down. Depending on what they did, their feet will be chained down. Depending on what they did on earth. Some of them will just be in a pit of fire, pit in hell, where they are not chained down. But some of them will be chained down. Some of them will be not only chained down, they'll be chained down and then locked like in a box where they can't, where other people cannot even access them. They are kept out of bounds, and they've got maybe two or three demons guarding them. Some of them are guarded 24 hours. They are never left alone. They've got demons guarding them throughout. Why? Because of what they did on earth. Especially those ones that were dangerous to the kingdom of the devil on earth, and then they backslided and died while they are still backslidden. When they go, the demons will torment them, will harass them, and then they'll be chained down, they'll be kept separately. Why? Because they used to cause damage to the kingdom of the devil, and then they backslidden, and then they died in that state, and now the devil will be tormenting them, will be harassing them back. Why? Because they went astray, or because of the works of the flesh. Maybe when they started, when they were doing well, when they were harassing the devil, for example, they were pastors or they were ministers in the Lord, they were doing the right things. Then suddenly a spirit of lust came on them. They started to go after women. And then when they died, they now went to hell. And now the devil will be harassing them. They put them in a box or they chained them down. And now the devil is saying, you caused damage to our kingdom when we were on earth. But then because of what later happened to them. So we've got to hold on to the word of the Lord. We've got to hold on, stand fast, hold the ground. Don't go astray, don't change. Go back to the love of the Lord that we had at the beginning when you first gave your life to Jesus. Don't follow the works of the flesh. Hold on to Jesus. In any way you think you have gone astray, go back to God. Ask him to forgive you so that you continue that fire that you had at the beginning. Will you continue serving the way the Lord, the way you used to serve him at the beginning? So that when you die, you'll be able to go to heaven. So that when you die, you'll be able to go and live in a mansion. In case you live in a mansion now. 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom, 4-bedroom, 5-bedroom. So that when you go to heaven, you'll be surprised. You might get a 10-bedroom mansion in heaven. You'll be surprised. You might get a 5-bedroom mansion in heaven. And you'll be surprised. And let me tell you one thing. The mansions in heaven are more beautiful than the mansions we see here on earth. So why do what will cause us to go to hell where the space is limited? Not doing what will cause us to go to heaven where there are mansions that have been prepared for us. They were not only prepared for us, we contributed by saving the Lord, by doing the right things in the Lord, by going out and evangelizing, by doing every good work in the Lord. Everything that we contribute, we do in the Lord, contributes to us, to the building of our mansions in heaven. But the question is, will we be able to go to heaven and live in the mansion? Or are we going to end up in hell where there's no space? The space is limited. Yet our Lord Jesus Christ had built mansions for us in heaven. And then we went astray, we followed the work of the flesh. And we went astray. No, we've got to go back to God. In any way we had gone astray, in any way we had followed the works of the flesh, we've got to go back to God and ask him to forgive us. And beg him to forgive us so that we walk right before him, so that in case he comes now, in case the trumpets are sounded now, we'll be able to hear. In case he appears in the sky now, we'll be able to see him if I will see him. But the question is, will be able to go? Rita, not everyone will be able to go. Not every Christian will be able to go. The time we have now is time for repenting. The time we have now is time for going back to him and asking him to forgive us in any way we have gone astray. So that when he comes, we'll be able to go with him and be partakers of the marriage supper. So that when he comes, we'll be able to go with him and live in mansions. Rather than living in mansions here on earth. And then when we die, we go to hell and live in this limited space. Maybe it's just a box, a one square meter. We are going to end up. Yet, a mansion had been built for you in heaven. Yet, everything had been prepared for you in heaven. Yet, everything had been done for you in heaven. But because of the works of the flesh, we went astray. Because of the works of the flesh, we end up in hell with the demons tormenting us. Why? Because of the works of the flesh. Rita, we've got to repent and go back to God and run away from the works of the flesh. Most of the Christians who concentrate on works of the flesh that are big, we classify them and say this one is big like murder. And we say, I'll not commit murder. If I commit murder, I'll go to hell. We classify them and say, oh, this one is big, like drinking alcohol, drugs and everything, and say, I'll not do that. But then we classify them and say, this one is small, like lying is small, so it's okay, I can get away with it, I can lie and get away with it. There's no way the Bible says you can lie and get away with it. There's no way the Bible says this one is a small sin, it will not take you to hell, and this one is a big sin, it will take you to hell. No. There's no way the Bible says this is a small work of the flesh, or this is big work of the flesh. No. The Bible, if you go to Galatians 5, 19 to 21, just says the works of the flesh. There's no big work of flesh adultery. There's no small work of flesh lying. No. They are in the same class. Jealousy, lying, adultery, fornication, they are in the same class. They are all works of the flesh. And we've got to run away from them. Oh, why? Because they are of the devil. Rita, because when we follow them and we do them and we practice them, we end up in here where the space is limited. Why? Simply because of the works of the flesh. Why? Simply because we follow the works of the flesh. Why? Simply because we refuse to run away from the works of the flesh. We have, Rita, to run away from the works of the flesh. We have to repent. In any way we've been following the works of the flesh, we've got to put an end to it today and say no to the works of the flesh and say no to the work of the devil and say no. We have to go back to God. We have to go back down on our knees and repent and ask God to forgive us. In any way we've gone astray, in any way we've followed after the works of the flesh. There are so many works of the flesh that people are following, people are practicing, and for them it's normal, especially in churches. But it's not of God. Rita, and God is not happy. Why? Because it is the works of the flesh. At the end of the day, he just said the works of the flesh. Take, for example, lying. He just said, do not tell lies. He told Moses, you shall not tell lies. But people are lying like it's normal. Especially in churches, people are lying and like it's normal. You'd think maybe there's somewhere in the Bible where it changed and said, oh, Moses made a mistake when he said you shall not tell lies. Now you can tell lies, things have changed. No, there's no way. Some say, well, we're living in a new era. Moses was Old Testament. Is there anywhere in the New Testament where the Bible says, now you can tell lies, it's now New Testament? Moses was in the Old Testament and he said, you shall not lie in the Old Testament, but now it's New Testament, it's new era, so you can lie. There's no way. The word of the Lord will send the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord will remain the word of the Lord. You shall not tell lies, you shall not tell lies. You tell lie, it's a work of the flesh. It will take you to here where the space is limited, even if you are living in a 10-bedroom mansion. But where are you going? Look at where you are going. Ask yourself, what is in your heart? Is your heart full of the works of the flesh? Or is your heart full of the word of the Lord? That will take you to heaven. That will cause you to go with him when he comes. What is it that is in your heart? You know what is in your heart. No one else knows except you and the Lord. And the Lord will ask you about what is in your heart on the last day. Rita, you'll have to explain. If your heart is full of works of the flesh, then you'll be too heavy to go to heaven and you end up going down. Because what is heavy goes down, what is light goes up. The Bible tells us about the works of the flesh in Romans 1 verses 28 to 31. The Bible says, And even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a debased mind to do those things which are not fitting, being filled with all unrighteousness. These are the things that are not fitting. Being filled with all unrighteousness, sexual immorality, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, strife, deceit, evil-mindedness. They are whisperers, backbiters, haters of God, violent, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, undiscerning, untrustworthy, unloving, unforgiving, unmerciful, who, knowing the righteous judgment of God, that those who practice such things are deserving of death, not only do the same, but also approve of those who practice them. So if you do those things, you practice those things, you deserve of death. Like I've always said, whenever the Bible mentions death, it doesn't mean that you die immediately. Whenever you die, maybe you did it when you were 15, and you keep it, you don't repent, and then you die when you're 100. When you die when you're 100, that's when this death, the Bible is mentioning, will take place. When the Bible says death, when you die, you go to hell. But when the Bible says you live, you go to heaven. So when the Bible says people who do these things, they will die, it means people who do these things, they will go to hell. So if you don't want to go to hell, you have got to run away from these works of the flesh. As the Bible has told us in Romans 1, verses 20 to 31, it listed the works of the flesh. And some of them, people do them, not knowing that they are works of the flesh. Some of them, people do them, not knowing that they will take them to hell. Things like boasting. So many people boast. Whispering. They'll be whispering bad things about someone else. It takes people to hell. It causes people to die. Some of them, the inventors of evil things, they come up with something evil. They invent it and then they teach others. They want it to spread. They want others to learn that evil thing and do it. They are all works of the flesh. They all lead to death. They all evil-mindedness, covetousness, sexual immorality. Let me read it again. Romans 1, verses, outside from verses 28. And even as they did not like to obtain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a debased mind to do those things which are not fitting, being filled with all unrighteousness, sexual immorality, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, strife, deceit. You think you are clever, you have deceived this one. Evil-mindedness. They are whisperers, backbiters, haters of God, violent. I've been looking for this one, that's why I had to read it again. Violent. You think you are violent and you are happy. Say, me, I'm violent. You are proud of being violent. It will take you to hell. It's not of God. It is the work of the flesh. Violent, proud, boasters, and you know how you boast. It's of the devil. You don't need anyone to remind you. You have to ask yourself where you are violent, where you boast, where you are proud. Go back to God and ask him to forgive you. Because it is the work of the flesh. It will cause you to go to hell, where you have a limited space. Boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents. Some children, they don't even know that when they are disobedient to parents, it will cause them to go to hell. They think it's okay. They think they've cheated their parents. They think they are clever than their parents. They think they've got ways to disobey their parents, not knowing that it causes them to go to hell. Parents, teach your children. Let them know that being disobedient to parents is a work of the flesh, and it will take them to hell. And discerning, untrustworthy, unloving, unforgiving, unmerciful, who knowing the righteous judgment of God, that those who practice such things are deserving of death, not only do the same, but also approve of those things, but also approve of those who practice it. Like if they see someone who is lying and they know it's not good, they approve of the liar, knowing that one, this one is a liar, but they still go on to approve the liar. They lie too and they approve liars. Maybe they are backbiters. They go and approve a backbiter, knowing this one is a backbiter, but they support a backbiter and approve a backbiter and promote a backbiter and lift up a backbiter. It will take them to hell. Why? Because it's not of God. Why? Because it's the work of the flesh. So we should not approve who the people who do it. We should not support people who practice the works of the flesh, like murder, backbiting, whispering, jealousy, covetousness. Instead, we should tell them to change and go back to God. The Bible tells us also in 2 Timothy 3, verses 1 to 5. But know this, that in the last days, perilous times will come, for many will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, they'll do everything, anything for money, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents. It is a sign of the end of the age. When you see children disobedient to parents, they know that it is a sign that the end is near. Unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power. And from such people, turn away. So we've got to turn away from such people. People who follow the ways of the flesh, who practice the works of the flesh, because the works of the flesh will take us to hell, where there's no space for us. The space is limited. Maybe we'll be in a pit, and hundreds and thousands and millions of people will be in that pit. Or maybe we'll be in a small space, small box limited, with hands chained, legs chained, no space, you can't move, you can't do nothing. And compare it with yourself now, when you've got 2 bedrooms, 3 bedrooms, 4 bedrooms, 5 bedrooms, you move around, you go to the kitchen, you go to the living room, you go to the kitchen, sitting room, you go everywhere, you go to the bathroom. In hell, there'll be nothing like that. But can I just remind you that in hell, it will be forever. There's no end to hell. Heaven is forever. There's no end to heaven. The time we have here on earth is limited. Maybe 100 years. No one is going to live 150 years here on earth. So there's no need to live in mansions for 150 years. And then you end up in hell forever. I'd rather live in a two-bedroom house for 150 years and then be in a mansion, 10-bedroom mansion, forever in heaven. Or live in a mansion on earth and then live in a mansion in heaven. Than to live in a mansion on earth and live on a square meter in hell. Or live in a pit where you don't even have a space. You are just mixed up. You'll be burning, going up and down in that pit of fire. No, we've got to change our ways. We've got to turn back to God. We've got to repent in any way we've been practicing the works of the flesh. That will cause us to go to hell. We've got to change, and the time to change is now. We've got to repent, and the time to repent is now. We've got to go down on our knees and ask the Lord to forgive us in any way we've gone astray, in any way we've been practicing the ways of the flesh. If you are a child, in any way you've been disobedient to your parents, it is time to repent now. It is time to go down on your knees and ask God to forgive you. If you are a child, in any way you've been influencing your friends to be disobedient, repent and go back to God and ask God to forgive you. In Jesus' name. Amen.